Hello everyone, welcome to Math Mastermind class. Today's topic is vertically crosswise method of multiplication. We call this as VCM. Vertically crosswise multiplication method. In this method, we will separate this into two parts. First part, we'll concentrate only on multiplying two digits with two digits. And the next part, we'll concentrate on multiplying three with three digits. This method, when we say vertically crosswise, we have digits in the ones place and the tens place. And what we do is, vertically, we multiply these ones place and tens place separately, and then we multiply crosswise and we take the sum of it. Now, to show you with an example, I take this 21 to be multiplied by 32. Identifying the ones and the tens place, this is the ones place and the tens place. The first step would be multiplying the digits in the tens place. You take the product of 2 and 3, which gives you 6. Second step, you take the product of the numbers crosswise and sum it up. Here the product of 2 and 2 is 4, the product of 1 and 3 is 3, and then when you sum it up, 4 plus 3 is 7. The last step will be multiplying the digits in the ones place. Here it's 1 multiplied by 2. You take this product and you write it here. And that's how you arrive at the solution for 21 multiplied by 32 as 672. Next we will address 2 by 2, where you have a carryover to be taken from the ones place to the tens place. That will be in the next session. Thank you. Continuing with the earlier session, now we look at multiplication of 2 by 2 digits. The only difference in this one would be that we are looking at carrying forward a multiple from the ones place to the tens place. So we keep in mind this method where you have the ones and tens. We vertically multiply the ones and tens place digits separately, and we cross multiply and add them. Take an example of 24 multiplied by 33. You identify the ones place and the tens place. For first step, take the product of the digits in the tens place. 2 multiplied by 3 will be 6. You then you cross multiply the digits in the ones place and the tens place and sum it up. Product of 2 and 3 is 6. Product of 3 and 4 is 12. The sum of 12 and 6 would be 18. We put a separator. The last step, this was the second step which we did. The last step is taking the product of the digits in the ones place. Here, the digits in the ones place is 4 and 3, product is 12. Now, how this is different from the previous version is, we have digits to be carried forward to the next place value. So here, by rule, we are only allowed to keep one digit in each placeholder. So we keep 2, we take this 1 and we add it over to 18. So it becomes 19, we keep the 9, and we take the 1 and we add it over to the next place value. So this becomes 6 plus 1, which is 7. So you arrive at the answer as product of 24 and 33 is 792. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and would be able to solve this problem faster. Thank you. Hello everyone. We continue with this lecture of vertically crosswise multiplication method. Today we will concentrate on multiplying 3 digits with another 3 digits. Here, the structure would be the ones, tens and hundreds place. You would vertically multiply these. You would also cross multiply the ones place with the tens place, sum it up. The tens place with the hundreds place, sum it up. And an extra step in this would be multiplying the hundreds place with the ones place with the hundreds place, and then having a sum. Okay, so we have 6 steps to this. First step would be vertically multiplying the digits in the hundreds place. So first I'll do with an example here, and I'll also correlate with the structure. If you take an example of 3, 1, 2 being multiplied with 1, 2, 3. We identify the placeholders. The first step would be taking the product of the numbers in the hundreds place. The product of 3 and 1 is 3. We add a separator before going to the second step. The second step would be multiplying crosswise the digits in the tens place and the hundreds place and summing it up. So when we look at this, the digits in the hundreds place is 3 and here it is 2. The product of it is 6. You sum up with the product of the digits in the tens and the hundreds place. So basically we are going to do this. And we will sum it up. So we get 6 plus 1, which is 7. We put another placeholder, separator over here. The third step is cross multiplying the digits from the hundreds place with the ones in the ones place at the bottom. Start with the digits in the ones place at the top with the hundreds place at the bottom. And also multiply the digits in the tens place. Sum all of this up. So we have the product of 3 and this 3, which is 9. Product of 2 and 1, which is 2. And this product, which is 1 and 2, is 2. So we have 9, we have 2, and another 2. So 9 plus 2 is 11. 11 plus 2 would be 13. The fourth step is cross multiplying the digits in the tens and the ones place. So product of 1 and 3 is 3. Product of 2 and 2 is 4. Sum of 3 and 4 is 7. And the final step, that would be product of the digits in the ones place. Here it is 2 and 3, which is 6. And as we learned in part 2 of multiplication of 2 by 2, there should be only one digit in each placeholder. So we keep 6, we keep 7. Here we can only keep 3. We keep 3 and we take this 1 and we add it to the next place value. So it becomes 7 plus 1, 8, and this is 3. So the final answer for the product of 3, 1, 2 multiplied by 1, 2, 3 is 3, 8, 3, 7, 6. In the next series, we will learn how to go ahead and multiply 3 digits with another 3 digits, where there are much more carryovers to be taken care of. Thank you.